Joining us now from Marshalltown, Iowa, is Donald Trump. Mr. Trump, thanks for being here.
Okay, thank you, Bret.
You know, you have said and talked a lot on the trail about your managerial skills to be able to make America great again. Many people say, here in Iowa especially, organization is a big part of it, almost essential. Do you think that a win here is essential to prove those abilities to the rest of the nation?
No, I don't think so, but I think we're doing very well. Today we had Jerry Falwell, who is a fantastic guy, Liberty University. He endorsed us. We had Sarah Palin endorse us. We have so many incredible endorsements. I think I would love to win Iowa. I'm doing very, very well with the evangelicals, as you know and as you can see. In fact, nationwide, we're leading with the evangelicals, which we're very proud of. And the Tea Party, we're doing fantastically well. I guess a poll just came out. We're at 42-11 nationwide overall. So we're doing very well. I think we've had great managerial skill, but I think we have a great message, which is maybe more important.
You know, in recent days also, you've been talking about your ability to negotiate and even negotiate with Democrats. Here's what you said this morning on this issue.
Well, I think that I'm going to be able to get along with Pelosi. I think I'm going to be able to. I've always had a good relationship with Nancy Pelosi. I've never had a problem. Reid's going to be gone. I always had a decent relationship with Reid. Hey, look, I think I'll be able to get along well with Schumer, Chuck Schumer. I was always very good with Schumer. I was close to Schumer in many ways. And, you know, it's important that you get along.
So your party, especially the base of your party, has been upset that Republicans in Washington are making too many deals with Democrats, that they're not standing up on principle. So what deals with Nancy Pelosi or Chuck Schumer would you do that would be okay with the base of your party?
Well, Bret, the problem is they're making bad deals. They're horrible negotiators, the Republicans. I mean, this last budget 2 weeks ago was a horror show. It funded things that the Republicans just totally stand against. It's a horror. Now, the fact is, I've always gotten along good with both sides. I think it's one of the good assets, but I know how to negotiate. I would have never made the deal that they made 2 weeks ago. And, you know, you can't just stand out in the middle of a floor like, as an example, Ted Cruz did it. He's, you know, saying this and that. In the meantime, he doesn't have one Republican that's endorsed him, not one senator Republican that's endorsed him. Now, how do you work with Republican senators and you have nobody that's even endorsed you? You need to create.
Sure, understood. I mean, but you're
Ronald
talking about
Reagan
Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer.
Excuse me. Ronald Reagan did it with Tip O'Neill. And I'm not saying I'll get along with him. I'm not saying anything. All I'm saying is I'll make great deals and we'll get them done. And we don't have to use executive orders and all this stuff that Obama's using, which at some point I would imagine the courts are going to overrule in one form or another. But we're not going to be opening our borders or closing our borders based on executive orders. We're going to do it. We will get along well. It's like Putin. Putin came out, said nice things about me, and everyone went crazy. They said, oh, isn't that terrible? Wouldn't it be nice if we actually got along with Russia and used Russia in order to get rid of ISIS and let them spend some of the money instead of us always spending the money? So I have good relationships with many people, and that's an asset. At the same time, I am certainly not establishment, and I don't care really what label they put on me, but certainly I'm not establishment. But now a lot of the people, they see what's happening where I have 42% in the polls and tremendous numbers, and they want to come in and they want to be part of the team, and we'll rebuild the Republican Party. Because right now, the Republican Party is a total mess, just like our country is a mess. We've had Barack Obama dictating for the last 8 years, almost 8 years, to the Republicans. Everything he wanted, he got. He's a lousy negotiator with Iran. He's a bad negotiator with everybody. But he's a great negotiator against the Republican Party.
Mr. Trump, you know, the powers of the presidency are far more limited to act unilaterally than the powers of a corporate CEO. Do you think that you, as president, would abide strictly by the Constitution, or would you modify things with executive actions to try to get things that you've talked about through?
I feel very strongly about our Constitution. I'm proud of it. I love it. And I want to go through the Constitution. That's what we want to do. I mean, we want to bring the Constitution back. If you look at the way Obama's ruling, it's just not right. It's not appropriate. It's not what our founders had in mind. So I feel very strongly about the Constitution and ruling through the Constitution.
You've been attacking Senator Cruz on his stance on ethanol, an important issue, obviously, for corn farmers here in Iowa. On the broader issue, what do you say about the government picking winners and losers?
I don't want the government to pick winners and losers. I don't want that. I want people to go out and form companies and go out and do it. But ethanol happens to be something that I believe in. I think it's very good. It's fuel. We never want to be under the auspices and the control of OPEC, Bret, like we were for many, many years. And it'll happen again. I mean, as sure as you're sitting there or standing there or whatever you are, because I can't see you, but it will happen again. I never want to see happen again, Bret. What happened, where we were totally controlled, where oil was over $100, and we were totally controlled. And by the way, there was plenty of it. It was all over the place. You couldn't find a ship to put it in. They were all full. It was total control and total dominance. I never want to see that again. I think ethanol is great, and I think it's great, frankly, for the state of Iowa, but I think it's great. And Ted Cruz is opposed to it. Now, by the way, he changed his mind. You know, 2 weeks ago, he came out, and he came a long way because he didn't want to lose the vote. But everybody in Iowa understands that that's phony business.
Sure, but you know there's another side to it. I mean, we asked people on Twitter to send in things, and Donnie Rick says, quote, if Mr. Trump can't be bought, why start pandering to the ethanol lobby?
I'm not pandering at all. It's another form of fuel. I like as many forms of fuel as we can have because someday we're going to need it. Right now we don't because prices are low and it's all over the place. But someday we're going to need it. And I think it's great. And it's also jobs in Iowa. And it's jobs, therefore, for the United States. I'm for the United States. And frankly, it's jobs for the United States. But it happens to be a lot of jobs for Iowa. It's very important.
Can you name one thing the government does now that it should not be doing at all?
Well, I think that we're too involved in regulation of the banks. We're making it impossible for people to get loans. I will tell you this, Bret. I have friends that are wonderful business people, but they're not substantial people, and they can't get loans. I'm calling up banks all the time and giving them recommendations, and the regulators are running the banks. I mean, you have the biggest bankers that are on your show, and you can speak to them. The biggest there are. And they're not running their bank. And they tell me, Donald, we don't even run these banks anymore. The regulators are running the banks. Dodd-Frank is a disaster in so many different ways. But I will tell you, one of the reasons our economy is doing horribly, and it is, by the way, doing horribly. Now you're starting to see it with what's going on Wall Street. That was the final part of the bubble, and it's looking like it's popping. Who knows whether it's popping now or in 6 months or in a year from now. But we're in trouble. But the banks are totally regulated to a point where no banker, as big as they are and as much as they get paid, is controlling their own bank anymore. And they're not making loans to people that want to put people to work.
Let me ask you something else. The Obama administration is loosening the regulations with Cuba and the trade embargo. If you had the opportunity to build a hotel in Havana, would you do it even if it benefited the Castro brothers?
Well, I think this. I think that opening up Cuba now is okay. It's been 50 years. It's a long time. I'm down in Miami. I have tremendous holdings in Miami. I deal with tremendous numbers of Cubans and Hispanics and have great relationships in Miami with people. I own Doral. I own Trump National Doral. Now it's Trump National Doral. We rebuilt it. I think that it's fine to open up Cuba. I think it's good. But I think that we're giving away a lot. You know, it's like the Iran deal. I mean, giving $150 billion, having horrible everything. We don't get our prisoners back until we give them the money. They put guns to the heads of our sailors. I mean, this is the way we negotiate. The Cuba deal, we should make a better negotiation. We could make a much better deal than we're making. We're getting nothing. Now I understand that Cuba wants payment, past payments, for the damage that they say we've done. Now, certainly you shouldn't make a deal until they drop that demand, but now they're making a very strong demand that they want us to pay them a lot of money. And Obama won't do that, and Kerry won't do that. Just like the other day, I saw Kerry saying that he doesn't know if some of the $150 billion, he assumes it's going to be used for terror. He assumes it's going to be used for terror. Then why did he give it? If he assumed that parts of it are going to be used for terror, Bret, why would he give it? So, you know, this is the way we negotiate. So I'm all for Cuba opening it up. But I do think, if it's going to open up, we should make at least a reasonably sane deal, not the deal that we're making right now.
Mr. Trump, we'll see you Thursday night, right?
We'll be talking. Let's see. I don't like the, frankly, I didn't like the press releases that Fox put out. It's like they're playing games, and I don't like it
we'll
when
all,
people play games
we'll
with
all
me.
Be there.
And they're playing games.
We'll all be there.
All right,
we'll
you'll be there.
Report.
I'm sure you'll be there.
Thanks.
All right.
Thanks, Mr.
Thank
Trump.
You very much.